We are under the bright lights tonight as MLB Network welcomes you to this presentation of Major League Baseball. Game one here in the month of May between the Detroit Tigers and the Kansas City Royals. The Royals have now won five consecutive games. They'll aim to continue their winning streak next. Danny Duffy will be on the mound for the series opener. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, every team needs a pitcher like this one here. His numbers aren't going to blow you away. Career ERA just under four. But one thing he does, he takes the ball every 5 days, throws strikes, and gives his team a chance to win every single time he goes out there. He'll be fun to watch in this one here today.
Digging in now, Victor Reyes. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Now the 2-1. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats and left. The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
Into the box now, Cameron Maben. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Dan Dero, we take a look at the Royals as they enter play here tonight. They come in riding a five-game winning streak, and they've really got things clicking.
Yeah, Matty, this team's coming together right now. They're playing dangerous baseball. You can tell the look in their eye. They feel good about where they're at. They've won a few games in a row, and they look to continue that trend today.
All even now, 2-2. Good night for baseball all in all. Game time temperature 63 degrees. Bases are empty, one man out. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
So now to the plate, Miguel Cabrera, and he fouls this one off. Two out, nobody on. And he sends it the other way toward right center. Phillips is on the move. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. So a relatively routine start for the top of the first here. Nothing for the Tigers in their half of the first. Kansas City coming to bat. Stay tuned to MLB Network. Daniel Norris gets the ball for the Tigers in this one. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that is a little bit up and down throughout points of his career. A career ERA just over four. When he's good, he can be really good. And when he's bad, well, let's just say he can be pretty bad at times. But it'll be interesting to see which one we see. He's a little bit of Jekyll and Hyde. Hopefully he's going to be a little bit more Jekyll than Hyde in this one here today.
Now in the box, Adalberto Mondesi. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. So, guys, these Tigers, as they begin play here tonight, they've been mired in a team-wide slump of late, as with the loss last time out, they've now dropped 8 of their last 9 decisions.
Yeah, Matty, this definitely looks like a situation where somebody's going to have to call a team meeting. I don't know if it comes from a veteran or the manager decides to close the doors for a second, but this team has not played well. They find themselves losing lately. They lost the last game. And they're going to need a spark to get this thing turned around.
Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base. And that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout. Keep that guy off the base path.
At the plate now, Alex Gordon. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. the head-to-head numbers with Daniel Norris. He's got 8 hits in 21 at-bats. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
One out, nobody on. That's foul off to the left side as he makes him do it again, 3-2. Another full count pitch home. This is hit the other way out toward left field.
Castro
is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. Whit Merrifield next to bat, and he's been tearing the cover off the ball these past few days, as you see there. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Here we go.
Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 1-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. Royals go down 1-2-3. And this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Here's Jonathan Schoop now, and as you can tell easily from the splits, he's really struggled away from their home ballpark. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two. He has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two.
You know, we'll see him work both sides of the plate with his curveball. Maybe not that far in, but he'll move that pitch around the zone to give it a different look.
And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2. CJ Krohn waits on deck. Three-two pitch. Count remains full. And another foul ball. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time. Skied into straightaway right. Soler is there. And that's the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the big first baseman, CJ Krohn. Two balls and a strike to CJ Krohn.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. To 2-2 now.
Yep.
And this is on the ground for Merrifield at second. And that's the second out. Next up for Detroit, Nico Goodrum, looking for better results than last night when he went 0 for 4 in that one. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Ricky Holiday.
Yeah, Dan, we got Ricky Holiday behind the dish tonight. I can't figure his zone out. He doesn't favor the hitter or the pitcher and can be a little too inconsistent at times.
D-Row, you hit the nail right on the head. I think one of the things we're looking for a consistent zone. If it's a tight zone, it's...
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Down in order go the Tigers. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. In is Jorge Soler. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. One and two, here it comes. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Scope has it, and that's the first out. And that brings in Hunter Dozier. A couple of hits for him in four trips in yesterday's game. The 1-1 home. Norris isn't really known as the kind of starter that goes deep into games. It's not that he isn't capable, I'm sure. He just hasn't been that guy that works deep into games with regularity.
Matty V, I'm not sure it's this guy's fault, but I think it's more the fault of the metrics and the way we look at pitchers now, trying to limit the number of pitches and the number of appearances they have with particular guys in the lineup.
2-2 to Hunter Dozier. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now the pitch. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning. Digging in now for Kansas City, Salvador Perez. And he comes into this one really slumping. The numbers there over the past several games, not very pretty. Bottom of the second here with no score. Changeup taken for ball three, well below the zone.
You know, when you haven't gotten a guy on base yet in the entire game, a three ball count kind of feels like a little mini rally. Let's see if he can get on.
The 3-1.
Hey, two. Hold down, 3-2.
Chopped on the ground over to first. Scooped up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. KC down in order. We'll move to the third with no score. The next batter, Jamer Candelario. 7-8-9, bottom of the order set to go here in the third. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. And the 2-1.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
That's a hit, the first of the game for the Tigers. Well, fastball count there yielded fastball, Mark.
Yeah, you drive to the ballpark praying to get in 1-3-1 count a night and buy yourself that guaranteed fastball, and he didn't miss it.
At the plate, Austin Romine called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now.
He dropped that curveball in for a strike right there. But don't kid yourself, that's a dangerous pitch. He needs to start thinking about maybe working that back door, or that could get some serious damage done to it.
Too high, ball three. Harold Castro is on deck. Candelario on at first, nobody out. And he struck him out.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him, and watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
Standing in now, Harold Castro. This one's down to third. Dozier brings it in. Throw gets him, two down. At the plate, Victor Reyes. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
The set and the 3-1 pitch. There's ball four. Here's Cameron Maben now looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Third inning, no score to this point. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Two and one, here it is. Hit the other way out toward right field. After it is Soler. And this one bounds around against the wall. And the run will score all the way from first. It's a 2-0 ball game.
This thing was a double or more the second it left his bat. He really drove it well, and it ended up one hopping the wall out there. And more importantly, he picks up two RBI along the way.
In now, Miguel Cabrera. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Here's the 2-1 home. And that's ball three now as it just misses below the zone.
Not a good spot to be in right now. A pitcher's falling behind in the count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. Phillips is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors and a runner left. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Tigers 2 and the Royals nothing. Back alongside Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian as Michael Franco gets set to start out the inning. Franco ahead with a 3-1 count now.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Now a drive by Franco. Deep left field. and it clears the stands. Wow, that landed on the patio out there. It's a solo shot here for Michael Franco. 7 home runs for him on the year now, and the Royals have cut the deficit now to 2-1. One is definitely worth looking at again with our show track technology. It had plenty of distance to get out of the park, and you can see why when it's hit at 115 miles an hour. That's not something you see every day. Into the box, Ryan O'Hearn. 2-1 to the Royals' first baseman. Swings through it for strike number 2.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor and swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Here now the 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Maben is there. Makes the play, one away. So next to the plate for the Royals, Brett Phillips, one run in and one gone so far this inning. Now the 2-1. Grounded back up the middle. Scope is there. In time to first, and there are two away. So it's back to the top of the order now. And striding toward the plate next will be Adalberto Mondesi. 1-1 is taken for ball 2. High and deep to right center. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he is into third with a 2-out triple.
And that's his second triple of the season. For some hitters, that's a career. Good swing and great hustle to pick up the 3-bagger.
Here's the left fielder Alex Gordon, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Here's the 1-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Castro is under it, and he makes the catch for out number 3. Some more of the colorful characters here at the ballpark tonight. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on MLB Network after this. Welcome back to Kauffman Stadium in Kansas City. We send it down to Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Tigers manager Ron Gardenhire during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the 2 runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Thank you, Heidi. So that'll bring up Jonathan Scope. Comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. One-one, and it's fouled away. Liner towards second, but this will be gloved out there at second as he didn't have far to go for the out. So that'll bring up CJ Krohn. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 2-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Stepping in, Nico Goodrum. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Grounded to short. Mondesi picks it up. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Detroit as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. Whit Merrifield next to hit. 0-for-1 after he took a look at strike three in his first plate appearance.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last time. I'm interested.
Oh, and he misses it. And you see on the graphic right there that his hitting streak will indeed live on as he just continues to hit the ball well. To the plate now, Jorge Soler. One ball and two strikes to count. Throw over to the bag, just keeping him close. The 1-2. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. Goes toward second. 2-2 pitch is fouled away. From the stretch. Heading out toward shallow right. Under it is Maven now as he pulls it in for the first out. Hunter Dozier digging in now. Now the 1-1 pitch. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Way late, and he's in there easily at second. Up. Candelario is calling for it. Two down. And up steps Salvador Perez as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. One run on three hits and no errors so far for the Royals. Fastball runs in tight here and it's 2-1. A little early and now it's even at 2-2. Here's the 2-2. Line drive base hit. Merrifield blows through the stop sign headed for home. And he will be tagged out at the plate. So it remains a one run deficit here as the side is retired. Set for the start of the inning. Digging in, Jeimer Candelario. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Here's the pitch. And this is popped up near second base. And this is taken in for out number one. Next for the Tigers, Austin Romine. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Right. 1-2 to the Tigers catcher. Ball two as the breaking ball misses inside. The 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Inside, he misses ball four.
I know one thing, he earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Digging in, Harold Castro, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Now the 2-1. Lifted in the air to center. Phillips is there for it. And that's the second out of the inning. So back at the top of the Detroit lineup, digging in, Victor Reyes. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Now the 2-1. Swing and a liner, but foul. Here now the 2-2. Swing and a little blooper to center. In comes Phillips. He can't get there, so the inning will continue.
Beggars can't be choosers right there. We love those long darts. Doesn't matter how they come. Jammed off the end of the bat, doesn't matter.
So now to the plate, Cameron Maben checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
Even though he was fooled in the box right there by that pitch, he was able to keep his hands back, not overcommit, and stay in this at bat.
Here's the 2-1. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Two runs, three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers. Hit sharply but foul down the right side. Two and two. Here it is. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Tigers strand a pair. They lead it 2-1. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with the Kansas City manager during the inning break about the Royals' offensive production to this point, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs, so the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Striding forward now is the DH, Michael Franco. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one.
We all know this guy's a real good fastball hitter. We saw how far he could hit one. He got a fastball that he liked, and he turned that thing around, and it got out of here in a hurry.
The 2-2 one more time. Line drive to center field. Reyes is there, and he has it for the first out. So yet another strong outing for him tonight as we show you the league leaders in ERA. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Stepping up now, Ryan O'Hearn. He flew out in his last at-bat. The 1-1. Some action now in the Tigers bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. Fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Making him sweat out there, the seventh pitch coming up. Full count now, 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch, and for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Stepping in now, Brett Phillips. A ball and two strikes now.
I know it's cliche and it's tired at times, but a well-located fastball down at the knees is still the best pitch in the game.
The 1-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. Royals go down 1-2-3. Our score remains 2-1. That'll bring up the veteran Miguel Cabrera. 0-for-2, he's flown out twice. Here's the 1-1 delivery. And he misses 2-1. Some activity out in the bullpen now as a couple of left-handers begin to stir. The 2-1 pitch.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate. That's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
The 2-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Phillips is there for it. Makes the play, one away. And next it'll be the Tigers cleanup hitter Jonathan Schoop. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. He's fallen behind now 3-1.
I can't tell you how big a pitch the last one was. The difference between 3-1 and 2-2. 2-2, you're probably taking a turn for the dugout.
Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Definitely had the distance, but it winds up a foul ball. 3-2 pitch. Grounded to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Here's C.J. Cron now. He's grounded out and struck out in his two trips to the plate. Two balls and a strike to the Tigers' first baseman. Ready with two balls and a strike. Hard on the ground towards short. Throw in time and the side is retired. Down in order go the Tigers. They still lead it 2-1. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Adalberto Mondesi. He tripled earlier, making him 1-for-2 in the ball game. A 2-1 count to the leadoff hitter for Kansas City. And he misses again, ball three.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
The 3-1.
Hey. We got 3-2.
Changed up on him as this is grounded to second. Taken in by Scope, and a good throw gets him one gone. Standing in, Alex Gordon. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-2 at this point. Two and one. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Reyes is there. Two gone. Ready for another chance. Whit Merrifield. He's 1-2 in this one. Two and one.
Very impressive outing so far. His command has been spot on. Even when he misses his spot, it isn't out over the heart of the plate. He's throwing quality pitches.
Now the 2-1 pitch is taken. Ball three.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
Hot shot to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. KC down in order. They're down 2-1. Jake Kalish is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Into the box now, Nico Goodrum. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Set to deliver on 2-1. A swing and a ground ball to third. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Digging in to try it again, Jeimer Candelario. A hit in 2 tries so far. We're in the 7th inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick 2 outs to start the 7th. So 2 outs now here in the Detroit half of the 7th. And up next, the catcher, Austin Romine.
Nope.
No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
One strike.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Soler is there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. 3 up, 3 down for Detroit as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Rony Garcia gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home 7th. Now it'll be the cleanup spot for the Royals. Jorge Soler. It's been an 0-2 effort for him to this point.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by 1. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
And he fouls this one off. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Here's another 2-2. Line toward center field. And that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-3 game so far. With that, the Royals have their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning.
They need to be aggressive right here from the offensive standpoint. Leadoff base hit, bottom of the seventh, you're down one. This has to be the moment they scratch one across.
Standing in now, Hunter Dozier. He takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Now the 2-1 is in there for the second strike.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Nobody out, runner on first. Takes this the other way to right. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. And the throw in gets away from him. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Well, it took him till the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he didn't come out of what he was trying to do all day, Dan. Kept the front shoulder tough, kept the ice water in his veins, and didn't try and get too big. Extends the hitting streak. Nice job.
You know, D-Ro, I talked to him before the game about the streak, and he said the toughest part is he hopes to get hits early in the game to take the pressure off. He had to wait to the seventh inning in this one to come through.
The 1-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Castro is there and he makes the catch for the out. So here's the Royals DH, Michael Franco. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
Well, the Royals have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a great time.
A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. At the plate now, Ryan O'Hearn. Out in front of that one, may have been looking fastball. Good job just to make contact. From the stretch, the 1-2. Just a bit low. A tough call, but it's 2-2. Back up the middle. Throw to second in time. What a play as the side is retired. Royals strand a pair. They still trail it here 2-1. Ready to begin the eighth, so coming to the plate, Harold Castro. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a liner. Foul. Hops this one up. And that's in there, base hit. So it's a leadoff base hit to open their half of the eighth.
Hey, sometimes that's how a rally gets started right there. I know it's a soft liner, but leadoff man on usually poses problems.
Into the box, Victor Reyes. And it's 2-1 to the Tigers' leadoff hitter. Line drive to center field. And that'll get down for a base hit.
No mistake what he was sitting on, looking for a dead red piece of cheese middle of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Stepping in, Cameron Maybin. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Fouled off. The 1-2. Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. Merrifield picks it up, and he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now. Next will be the designated hitter, Miguel Cabrera. It's been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
This is a situation where you're going strictly for the strikeout. Infield in, and from the offensive standpoint, you're just trying to create hard contact and get it by that infield.
2-2 the count. Second and third here, one man out. Three balls and two strikes to the Tigers' designated hitter.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
Hit out towards second. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow! Now at the plate, Jonathan Schoop. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Runners at second and third with two gone. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But this one will bend foul. Had plenty of distance, though, as it landed in the upper deck. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Tigers strand a pair. They lead it 2-1. Brett Phillips will bat next, and he'll start out the bottom of the eighth inning. Three-two pitch. High in the air out to center field. Reyes is right there, one down. Ready for another shot now, Adalberto Mondesi. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Bases are empty, one man out. Sliced hard on the ground. Schoop has it, and there's out number two. Joe Jimenez enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Stepping into the box, Alex Gordon. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Reyes is under this one as he tucks this one away to retire the side. Royals go down 1-2-3. Our score remains 2-1. Ready now, CJ Krohn. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Mario. One and one, here it is. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. One and two. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at two and two.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Count remains two and two. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at three and two.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 3-2 one more time. Swung on and chopped up the middle. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Striding into the box, Nico Goodrum. He was a ground-out victim last time up. One-run game here in the top of the ninth. On the ground to the right side, Merrifield scoops it up. Throw gets him, two down. Into the box now, Jeimer Candelario. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Shatters the bat as this is hit on the ground. The flip to the pitcher covering as that will retire the side. Down in order go the Tigers. They still lead it 2-1. Buck Farmer comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Ready once again, Whit Merrifield. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Here's the 1-1. Up middle and off his leg. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it, it looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Jorge Soler. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. The runner at first with no outs here. 2-2 to Jorge Soler.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
Working for the punch out and the offering. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
At the plate, Hunter Dozier. Pitch misses low. The throw down. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
90 feet is a big deal when you're talking about a one-run game, so that's a little risky. But, hey, sometimes you have to be aggressive and force the other team to stop you.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
To the plate now, Salvador Perez. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Hit hard on the ground is short. Reined in. Oh, and it sailed right over his head at first. And now this ball's going to wind up out of play. And that'll compound matters even further.
And don't forget, on a ball thrown out of play, the rule says that the runner gets the base he was running to plus one more.
Now batting, Michael Franco. And he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. Question is whether they'll even pitch to him. From the stretch, the 1-2. And it looks like a right-hander's got enough to throw in the Tiger bullpen. Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. And it's fouled away. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Reyes will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. So this game will not end here in the bottom of the ninth as they push across the equalizer, and we're right back where we started from. 10th inning coming up, and we are tied 2-2. We are into extra innings, so stepping in, Austin Romine. No hits to this point. 50th pitch of the game on its way. There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. Phillips looks up. On to the lawn and gone. So it's a solo shot to dead center. As they've taken the lead, it's now 3-2.
Somebody is anxious to end this thing and get the heck out of here. We'll see if that leadoff homer stands up. Either way, that's definitely a way to start the extra frame.
Into the box now, Harold Castro. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Soler is there, and that's the first out of the inning. Digging in and looking for more, Victor Reyes. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. One out, nobody on. And he just misses inside with the fastball there. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Swing and a liner. Foul. The 2-2. Cameron Maben will be next. Bases are empty, one man out. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Gordon is there. Two down. Coming to the plate now, Cameron Maben. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Skied into straightaway right. Soler is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So just the one hit in the inning, but it's a home run that pushes him out in front. So now we'll see if these guys can get even in the bottom of inning number 10. It's the Tigers 3 and the Royals 2. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. So digging in now, Ryan O'Hearn. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Fouled away. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
So now to the plate, Brett Phillips. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 2-2. One out, nobody on. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
With how hard guys throw these days, 94 miles an hour is good, but not as impressive as it used to be. Professional hitters can catch up with that, so it's all about setting the fastball up with good off-speed stuff to make it look more effective, and that's exactly what he did right there.
In now, Adalberto Mondesi. Two balls and a strike to count. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Full count now, 3-2.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it. But hey, they're not going to complain as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Buck Farmer claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney on the field, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.